Anybody ever been to Canada? Like, I'm talking about like real Canada, not like punk ass Toronto or fucking, what's the other one?
Vancouver.
Okay. Vancouver. Like, all of it's bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Because what's the first thing y'all think about when you think of Canada?
No.
Coal. Okay, but no, we finished that part. You missed that. We done, boop, turn the page. Listen, we're on characteristics right now. You got any extra seats over there? Especially, you know, I'm just joking. You can't be doing that shit, you know. Cause you know, like when I was growing up, remember it was like the class and it was like the dumb motherfucker. You know, he sat next to the teacher. He's a dumb motherfucker. Back then, you just call him dumb motherfucker. You know, nobody call him that because he's strong. But now it's like all types of different levels, all kind of shit I never heard man before. Like, remember when it snowed real bad, like 3 years ago, right? In the apartment complex I live in, a buddy of mine, this motherfucker got 4 kids, all under 6, no twins. Let her rest, motherfucker. So, that's a lady joke. And he didn't have no power. I'm like, yo, man, bring the kids over here, man. Watch movies and shit and all this other shit. And so he came over and shit. And you know how he stopped me? Okay, y'all, we're going to play some games. And his little boy went right through my motherfucking legs with his snow boots still on with snow and magic mud. Dog shit. And this motherfucker started bouncing on my motherfucking couch. And the couch is white. It's not leather or suede, it's just white. Listen, yeah, come on, man. Look, he only 6. So you know what you say to a 6-year-old when do something like that. Hey, motherfucker, get the fuck up. What the fuck is wrong with this motherfucker? You know, he gonna look at me and go, come on, Tony, man. He's autistic. I'm like, I don't give a fuck if he can paint. Look. Nigga, what? Because I never heard that word before, everybody. And plus, my friend got a fat tongue, so I ain't talking like this. Right there, now I'm talking, man, he's on tenting. So. I should tell you some things before I tell you other things. Because it make y'all judge me. We gotta get back to where I was telling you about Canada. But like not Vancouver or nothing like that. Like real Canada. No dude, like I was like 5 exits from Santa. Motherfucker, I was way up top. Like, have you ever felt the type of cold we go, ooh, I could die? Yes, motherfucker. I'm talking about what, motherfucker? It was cold, but it was an unassuming cold. It was dangerous, right? And right, but everything up there is so big and shit. No bullshit, right? Because after we did the show, we met some dudes who was from there. 3 dudes, right? Listen, the little one was this big. The little one. The other two was even bigger. I know y'all say, so what? We seen tall dudes before, but guess what? They was Mexican. Yes, and I was like, what kind of avatar Mexicans is this? And that's when my man said, nah, Tony, them Indians. I'm like, what? I'd never seen them in real life. But that's okay, because they live in a remote area of the world. And guess what? They had never seen a real one of me.
Well.
Yup. And they was asking me stupid white boy questions. You know, like stupid white boy questions like, my friend, do you know Puff Daddy? No, bitch, all of us don't know each other. What is the what's up thing about? Because that's how Native Americans talk real slow. Because the guy, You Native American? Come on, you Native American motherfucker, I'm joking. Don't let him go to his car. He gonna come back here. Fuck. Ah! I was joking, high waffle. No, listen, I'm gonna tell you, it was like I said, it was unassumingly cold. It was no bullshit, it was real cold, right? And so we did the show, and the hotel was 3 blocks away. Like, that's nothing here, 3 blocks. But there, the air is so thin, like, ooh, I'm tired. Like, and you see a lot of shit in that part of the world. You're like, look at that fat motherfucker with that fur coat on. That's a fucking polar bear. Like, that motherfucker. Because if you ever seen a bear, they look like a fat dude with a suit on. So my man was telling us, he says, I have to tell you something, right? Because it was 20 degrees below zero. 20 degrees here above zero is cold, it's uncomfortable. 20 degrees below zero up there, you're like, this ain't so bad. I mean, my fingertips blue, but I'm good. Right there. But it's some other shit, because it's unassumingly, dangerously cold, right? So he says, I'm going to show you something. He says, and he says to the women, he says, the ladies can leave. Yeah, that's what he said. Like, he ain't gonna have to tell them. But because he was telling us, as we was drinking, he said, now, if you want to stop and pee, I have to tell you this, because you don't have to tell women that, because women only pee outside in extreme situations. You know, usually they drunk than a motherfucker, and they, you know, they pull over. Now go right here and go up there and pull over. Oh shit, I gotta pee. Come on, go over here and pull. Okay, and then they get out the car and they go, don't watch. And you always go, yeah, I ain't gonna look. Because no, we like to see y'all pee. Okay, is that freaky? No, listen. No, listen. No, because you see her, she's like, No, it's not like a nasty, freaky thing. It's fucking science. Like, what the fuck? Like, if you know women pee, they be like. You be like, how the fuck is she not taking flight? Like, she should be flying around the city. Because if you go in the women's bathroom right now, right beside the toilet, they got a bar. So keep them from bumping their head. They're like, psst, pow, ah! And see, because that's what women do. Women get drunk, they go, pull over, I gotta pee, right? If a man announced he gotta pee when he drunk, he already peeing, right? We say, hey man, hold up, y'all. I gotta pee. We already peeing, you know what I'm saying? So he did this, he says, watch this. And he goes, and spit up in the air real high. And it came down, pow, and it broke. We was like, whoa, like that. Like, we was like, motherfucker, I'm listening now. What's going on, son? And he said, if you find yourself having to relieve yourself outside in this climate, I know. That's what Native Americans do. They keep fucking talking. You're like, motherfucker, it's cold, finish. He said, if you're going to pee outside, you got to remember to wiggle your dick the whole time. No bullshit, because if you just stand there and pee, it'll freeze from the ground up and poof, your dick will explode right in your hand like, ah! Like, poof, like motherfucker! And it's even worse if you one of them motherfuckers who not circumcised, because you ain't gonna know till you get home. And you pull the skin back, your dick just fall like, ah! It exploded in the casing. You old turtle dick motherfucker. Is this not educational? There you go. Yeah. Wiggle your dick, dog.